Deborah, you are the first today. You know, cooking would be no fun without no jazz, so we'll try to give everybody an opportunity to get in. How you doing, Kimberly? Hello, Rochelle. Dinah, Kim, Linda, how y'all doing? Hey now, Stormy, how we doing? I hope you guys got your favorite adult beverage going on. Thank you, Sandra. And we're gonna have a little bit of fun. We got everything all prepped up and ready to go. Should be a little bit of fun. All right now, how we doing? Thank you guys for sharing the video. Waiting to eat, that's what I'm talking about. Man, this is gonna be a fun dish. I've never done it before. So it's gonna be really interesting for me to make this for you guys. By all means, if you're in the area, come on, stop by. This is an open invitation. I'm gonna have about 6 of these bell peppers done. There's no way I'm gonna eat all of this. So let me know if you're in the area. Come on through, I'll shoot you my address and we can have some fun. Irma, Deborah, and Ariana, how you doing? TD, what's going on? I'm trying to give everybody an opportunity to get in before we get started. So if you didn't see, today is gonna be seafood stuffed bell peppers. Let me know if the music is too loud. Somebody complained before saying the music was too loud. Let me know what you guys think. Is the music too loud? Can you hear me? I want to make sure we're good to go with that so there's no distraction on what we're trying to do today, all right? So, thank you guys for sharing the video. Thank you for the hellos. What's up, Kimberly in Connecticut? How you doing? Annabelle, hey girl, I know you was waiting on this one. Thank you guys first and foremost for the suggestions. I didn't know what to fix, and I was really struggling on what to do. I wanted to do something different, and I wanted to make sure that you guys were able to participate in that. So that's why I sent out the previous message. Thanks everybody for the music. Okay, good. All right, good. I just want to make sure that you guys were able to participate and what I try to cook out here and show you guys what's going on. I got a lot of suggestions. 2 things I love, seafood and seafood. So some, a lot of people stopped throwing out some suggestions for seafood, and then I saw several suggestions for stuffed bell peppers. The fact that you guys threw out the stuffed bell pepper suggestion, I said, you know what? That's not a bad idea. Let me take those stuffed pepper, bell pepper ideas and try to mix it in with my seafood love. And so that made it sounds like, no, I'm good. The music, this is just me talking loud because it's just me. I'm a loud talker, so we good on the music. If it gets to the point where it's too loud, I'll go ahead and turn it down for me. But to take those 2 things and put them together, I think it's gonna be real good. I had to dig through a couple of recipes to try to see what would be a good mixture of everything. There's no rice in this at all, actually. And I know most people are used to doing stuffed bell peppers and adding rice. Just a second. Give me just a second. So anyway, I know most people do stuffed bell peppers and they have rice in it. I don't have any rice in this at all. It's not gonna need it because there's so much seafood in this that it's gonna be pretty much stuffed. Hello, Sarah. Hello, Kim. Hello, Bridget. Hello, Teresa. Let me scroll back a little bit. Tracy Battle, how you doing? Leola, how you doing? Linda Wiggins, how you doing? Felicia Johnson Miles, how are you? Kimberly Joanne Jones Murphy, how you doing? Just want to get a couple of hellos to you guys. Let you know I do see you. Hello, Sarah, Bridget, Sherry. Thanks for watching in. All right. So basically, with the seafood pasta, I got seafood pasta on the mind. But for this dish, we're gonna have three things inside the meat-wise. We're gonna have shrimp. We're going to have my favorite, crawfish tails, and we're going to have lump crab meat. If you guys see this here, this is lump crab meat. You can find this at Costco. It is rather pricey. It's $17.99 for this, but it's worth it. You get a whole pound of it. Hello, Miss One of a Kind. Hello, Angela, Felicia. All right, so here's what you're gonna need, basically, for your ingredients on this one. So if you're ready to write this down, I want you to go ahead and get it together. You're gonna start out with you're gonna have a half a stick of butter. Just regular old butter. Basically, you're gonna have a half a pound of crawfish tails. You're gonna have a half a pound of peeled deveined shrimp. You're gonna have a half a pound of lump crab meat. For your veggies, you're gonna have a half a cup, and I got everything cut up. This is garlic, half a cup of minced garlic, half a cup of celery, half a cup of onions. I got some fresh parsley here, but I'm gonna cut that up at the end and mix it in. You're gonna have Italian style breadcrumbs. Okay, I got this over at Kroger's. Some Italian style breadcrumbs. Hello, Tara. Hello, Samaya. All right. With that, you're gonna need some hot sauce, because we know in Louisiana, ain't no hot sauce better than Louisiana hot sauce. So we got some hot sauce, some Cajun spice, which is our Louisiana spice as well. And then I'm gonna throw in a little bit of Old Bay seasoning, because I like to give it that little bit of seafood flavor. And then we're gonna add a little bit of black pepper to taste. Hello, Angela, how are you? Jeanette, how you doing? Mr. Lawrence, thank you for watching. All right, so basically, the most important ingredient, you're gonna take 6 bell peppers, you're gonna cut the tops off of them, you're gonna take the seeds out of the middle. I do use cilantro, but this recipe does not call for cilantro. And you're gonna cut the tops off of them, and you're gonna take some salt water, and you're gonna parboil your bell peppers in water for about 10 minutes, okay? So I'm gonna show you these here. I already got them set up and ready to go. They've already been parboiled, emptied, and ready to stuff, okay? So that's where those are sitting. So now that we got everything together, I'm trying to get this set back up. Now that we got everything together, you know this. Oh man, you had Papa Do's, man. You're something else. So, Ebony, thanks for joining me. Virginia, thank you for joining. Mercedes, how you doing? Tracy Spencer, thank you for joining. Thank you for sharing the videos, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much. All right, if you would hold off on the instant messages, please, until at the end I get to you. I don't mind you asking questions via here. If I see them, I'll try to get to them as soon as I can. But please hold off on the instant messages, because it kind of disrupts my feed. Thank you so much. Appreciate you. All right, so got a little bit of, I got some Merlot today. Oh, I'm sorry, some Cabernet Sauvignon today. And we're going to have a little fun. Yes, I'm in Dallas. Yes, yes. You want to submerge the bell peppers in the water, because you want them tender. You don't want them tough. All right. So anybody got any questions before we get ready to get started? Because it won't take long, because I got everything already prepped out and ready to go. And we're going to have some fun with this. Give me just one more second. All I had to get my monitor part here going. Wait a minute, Nico, wait a minute, going on with your cigar? You said you was gonna ship me some cigars, brother. I've been waiting on them cigars. I ain't seen nothing from you yet on there. So I'm giving everybody a little chance to get caught up here, and I still got people still joining the feed. So give me a little bit here before we get started, because I don't want someone to kind of come in late and then have a lot of questions, and I want to go ahead and try to knock everybody out in one shot, if y'all don't mind. Margaret, thank you for watching. Susan, thank you for watching. Tiff, Keith, thank you for watching. Got my little tablet going on here. If I didn't catch your name, post something, I'll definitely catch your name. Thank you, Sharon, appreciate it. Thank you for all sharing the video as well. Oh man, what's going on, cigar, bro? What kind of line? Nico, I love Merlots. Love them. Michelle, thank you for coming in. Arata, thank you for showing up. Give me a second here. I'm just trying to get everybody in. Is the music okay? Can you hear that? y'all doing too much now. That ain't that kind of show now. We keeping this show strictly G-rated, all right? G-rated. All right. So, okay, music's okay. Good, good, good. I know this phone picks up some really good sound. Thank you, Margaret. All right, so, okay, cool. Good deal, good deal. Let me finish looking up my little deal. I forgot one thing. One more thing. That wasn't the one I needed. I'm almost there. Just give me a little bit. The food, I'm getting ready to prep. I got some people that I know that are gonna be joining that hasn't joined yet. I'm just trying to give them an opportunity to get in, and then once they get in, we'll go ahead and get started. It won't be a long video because everything is pretty much prepped. The longest thing it's going to take is for it to actually cook in the oven. That's going to be the longest time we have. All right, so we're almost there. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and what I have here is I took my crawfish and my shrimp. I put them in the same pan. Reason why is because I'm gonna go ahead and mix this up in the skillet together. All this is gonna be cooked in together, all right? So we're gonna take this mixture, and I'll pour off some of this juice. Oh shit, I'm also trying to do that. All right, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this mixture here, I'm gonna put it in the skillet, I'm gonna go ahead and put my butter in the skillet and get it going. Second. I'm gonna put the butter in the skillet and get it hot and going. And we're basically gonna saute all the ingredients in the butter, and we're gonna get that going. All right. So we'll get that in the skillet. I'll show you what that looks like once I get everything in the skillet. Welcome, Rashonda. Hello, Billy. How you doing? So we get all that together and we're gonna be rolling. So I'm gonna let the butter melt right now in the skillet, and we'll get it going. All right, I know you, this is my live feed. And this is not too much different than TV. You don't have any commercials. And I know we look at the TV and say, come on, come on, come on, come on. We're gonna get there. Cooking's a patience, you know? Hold on, we're gonna get there. We're gonna have some fun with it at the same time. I try to address any questions anybody's having at the time while we're doing this. Chantel, welcome, thank you for joining. So we're almost there. So process is I gotta let the butter heat up in the skillet, and I'm gonna toss everything in with the exception of the crab meat, okay? We're gonna saute these things, the shrimp, the crawfish tails, the celery, the garlic, and the onions for about 10 minutes, and we're gonna saute. We're gonna use a half a stick of butter, one half stick of butter. Hello, Keisha, how you doing? So we're gonna use a half a stick of butter. With that half a stick of butter, we'll get that hot and we'll toss everything in, and we're gonna saute that for about 10 minutes. All right, welcome, Lisa, welcome. Thank you for watching. All right, so give me a minute, let the butter do what it do, let it melt, get hot, and we're gonna toss this all in the skillet, and then we're gonna get it going. How about that? Just give me a second. In the meantime, sip on a glass or something. Thank you, Annabelle. Tell them how it's done. Grab a glass of Cabernet Sauvignon, Moscato, Pinot Grigio, whatever's your flavor. Grab it, sip on it for a minute, sit back and relax for a minute, and once we get done, it's gonna be done. Because when it's over, you're gonna hate it's over. All right, because it's just gonna be over. So enjoy while it's lasting. I'm having fun with you guys. So let's do it. Yes, I can post the recipe when I get done. I will do that. I'm not going to use a real big cast iron. I do have a heavy skillet. And the reason why I'm using this heavy skillet, but it's a little bit deeper than a regular cast iron skillet. It's a little bit better. Hello, Georgia. Yes. I know people like to drink wines. I love wines myself. It's going to be what it's going to be. So I wouldn't mind doing a little bit of Pinot Grigio myself. Yeah. Tracy, how's it going? Yes, thank you. Appreciate it. And we'll use a little bit of that parsley on the top at the end. All right, so butter's getting hot. I'm going to relocate this over here so you guys can actually see what's happening. I don't want you to miss this at all. I don't want you to say you couldn't see it. We can hear the butter going off in the skillet. But we're going to have everything going right up in here. Give me a second. Let me get this posted up here. Get a good view of this real quick. Alrighty, so there's my skillet. The butter's getting hot. Alright. Gonna toss our celery in. Toss our garlic in. And then we're gonna toss the onion in, okay? Get all that going. All right. Boy, all of those together smell really good. We're gonna go ahead and toss the shrimp in and crawfish tails. All right. I got my fire on high. All right. You can smell it already. All right, thanks, Melissa. So we're gonna get all these mixed in together. Break these tails off and separate them a little bit. Gonna get that sauteed up and going. Our oven temperature today is gonna be at 350 degrees. All right. So we're gonna be at 350 degrees, and we're gonna let this heat up. It kind of cooled off the skillet a little bit. We'll get that going. All right. So as you can see, that's in the skillet. We want to saute this. We want to get the shrimp cooked. We definitely want to get everything mixed in together. The crawfish tails are already done, but we want to make sure the shrimp are done at the same time. So let's go back and look at the questions here. How much onion? Okay, so we're going to be using a half a cup
of garlic, a half a cup of celery, and a half a cup of onions. All right, one half cup. I went and did what someone suggested today, and I went ahead and bought me a food processor. I'm so used to cutting stuff by hand, but the food processor definitely helped on time. And so thank you for tuning in, Don. We got everything going here. Basically, we're going to be making a seafood stuffed bell peppers today. All righty. Hello, hello, Alicia. Yep. So, welcome, Lisa Murphy. How you doing? Hello, Mary. So, we're sautéing everything up right now, getting it together. As you can see, it's going to be pretty nice looking right there. Crawfish tails right there. We got some nice shrimp in here. It calls for the small shrimp. All I had was large, and I bought a pack of medium, and I just cut them up, you know, just to get them going. Yeah, just get it all mixed up and going. Hello, Beverly Jones. How are you? Yay, food process. And you know what, Annabelle? I ended up with in the mail a certificate from Costco from my last year's spending, and I went ahead and used that to buy my food processor. So that turned out already. No stock today, Michelle. No requirement for stock at all. All right. So there was no requirement for stock in this one here. And so basically, as you saw, I got everything going in this skillet. And I'm trying to get this sauteed up. We're gonna go for another 5 more minutes in here and keep it going. No stock today. Ooh, but that smells so good. And we haven't even gotten to adding in the lump crab meat yet. Which, by the way, I need to go ahead and open up. And the reason why we didn't add any stock to this is because even though I had drained out all of the fluids, and I only used a half a stick of butter, it's quite a bit amount of fluid because of the vegetables are letting off their own juices. No, we're not gonna add any tomatoes to this. This recipe does not call for any tomato sauce. All right, this is gonna be a seafood deal, and we want it to do what it does. So what's too long to cook the shrimp? If your shrimp is tender, if it's tough, you cook it too long. Depends on your heat and your cooking method. Shrimp doesn't take very long to cook at all. You just want it to be completely white and all of the opaque grayness gone from it. Today I'm making stuffed bell peppers, seafood stuffed bell peppers. Not your traditional rice and tomato and ground meat. This is seafood stuffed pasta. Because I love seafood, and I took most of you guys' suggestions for this. I bought the crab meat at Costco. This is the brand. What is this? Pasteurized lump crab meat, and it's made by Phillips, and it is actually $17.99 a pound. Yeah. So, all right. So we got this going here. It's time to go ahead and add our crab meat. I'm gonna drain what juice there is on it off. All right, so lump crab meat. This is the next meat that goes in. So we got whole shrimp, raw, peeled and deveined, and lump crab meat looks like this. It is nice. There is no rice in this at all. In this recipe, there's no rice. So I know most people are traditionally used to seeing bell pepper stuff with rice. This is a seafood because we're using 3 things. We're using crab meat, lump crab meat. We're gonna be using crawfish tails and shrimp. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and add this in here. A little problem, a little thing there, but we're gonna add this in there. Lump crab meat. We'll turn the fire down. All right. So all the lump crab meat is in. It is, it did not say if it was blue crab or not. Let me see here. It did not say if it was blue crab meat, but it is lump crab meat. So, I'm gonna let you guys see what this mixture looks like now with what we have in here. Alrighty, so this is what we got going on here. Lump crab meat added into the mixture. So we got our shrimp, crawfish tails, and lump crab meat. What's up, Cousin Lisa? How you doing? Yeah, crab meat is not expensive. It's not cheap. It is. It is not cheap. But it's absolutely delicious. I promise you, it's going to be the bomb. All right, we're going to cook this for another 5 minutes. And then the next thing we're going to do is we're going to be adding in our breadcrumbs. And then we're going to be adding in our cheese. All right, so let's give that a few minutes to cook. Any questions so far? I want to take this, give this a good stir. We'll cook this for about 5 more minutes. All of you people tell me what you want to taste. If you're in the Dallas DFW area, you might want to make your way over here, because I'm not going to eat 6 bell peppers tonight by myself. I'm not probably going to even eat one. I just finished off the rest of that crawfish pie and some rice before I started this because I was hungry. And I said, well, let me put something on my stomach before I start doing anything. The recipe is going to be good. It's awesome. I think everyone's going to like it. And I'm going to do the seasoning here in a second. So, I'm going to do a little bit of our Louisiana seasoning. I like the taste to make sure it's not too salty. Gotta be careful with the salt content on that one. I'm going to add a little bit of Old Bay seasoning, just for the seafood flavor. I'm going to add in a couple of dashes of hot sauce. Yeah, just a few. All right. I'm going to take my cracked pepper. Just a dash. All right. And I'm going to get my cheese together and my breadcrumbs. We got our breadcrumbs together. We got our cheese together. The breadcrumbs, the Italian breadcrumbs, is going to call for 1.5 cups of Italian breadcrumbs, okay? 1.5 cups of Italian breadcrumbs. And then we're going to have 1 cup of shredded cheddar cheese, okay? Good old Louisiana hot sauce, you better know it. The jazz is always going to be going. Oh, that smells absolutely delicious. Oh my God. So, we're almost there. And then the longest process is going to be, welcome Francine, it's gonna be putting this in the oven for about 30 to 35 minutes. Well, the recipe, the Italian breadcrumbs are much finer, and it has seasoning in it, okay? It's an Italian seasoning as well, okay? That's why not regular. This is actually seasoned breadcrumb, and it's an Italian one. Let's see here. Thank you, Tamara, for sharing the video. Yes, it's gonna be good. it's impossible for it not to be seafoody. No. Well, that depends on your palate, okay? I can't say that because everyone's palate is different. So I don't know. So we're almost done. We're going to be able to mixture this up. So what's too seafoody for you? Some people say one piece of salmon is too seafoody for them. They can't stand the aftertaste or the taste of salmon. It's too fishy. So that's just one piece of meat. So for some, what's too much seafood is going to be depending entirely upon you, you know? Hey, if you know where I'm at, Robert, come on through, brother. You already know. Bring a couple of sticks with you when you do come, though. That's all I'm going to ask you to do. You know good and well you can't come without a cigar. So, anyway, we're almost done with this here mixture as far as it cooking. I'll give it another minute or two on the stove and just get that all mixed in. And then we're going to take it off the heat. We're going to take it off the fire. And at that time, when we take it off the fire, is when we're going to add in our breadcrumbs and our cheese mixture. And then we're going to go ahead and start stuffing the bell peppers from there. All right. Not a problem, Sherelle. It's going to be fun. I enjoy this. This is so much fun for me. Again, I always get asked, why don't you get a YouTube channel? The reason why I don't want to get a YouTube channel is, number one, most of you don't probably have YouTube. I get most of my followers here on Facebook. Secondly, the YouTube Live, I'm not too familiar with it. And then thirdly, this music I'm playing in the background, they would totally not let me do this. So plus, the fourth reason was is that I like Sereno Cigars, brother. Take them. I take it. And I love interacting with you guys, and that's why I do this, because I get to talk to you and listen to your questions and talk about what we're doing here. Stuffed salmon, definitely a good way to go. I'm in Cedar Hill. If you're familiar with Cedar Hill, Midtown Cedar Apartments, right behind the Walmart. You know where it's at, you know where to be. If you show up, I'll give you my apartment number. Until then, I'm not going to do that. Everybody can't have my address, so. We got one more minute on this one here, and we're going to be going ready to take it off the heat. And then we're going to start stuffing beautiful bell peppers. You think about that. I love different colors. So that's why I started doing, I did three different colors just to have something different to do. All right. So that's how we're doing it. Yeah, so we got all three different colors of these. They are ready to go. We're going to go ahead and take this off the fire now. We're going to shift this around a little bit. Get it off the heat. Alrighty. And you know what? I just may just go ahead and put this in a bowl just to get it off the heat, and then I can relocate it. We parboil the bell peppers. Okay, so basically all I did was took a big pot and filled it with some water and placed them in there in the water. That's all we did. Alright. The bell peppers are going to taste the same. There's nothing different about them. We just boil them a little bit, parboil them, to get a little bit of flavor. Actually, to tenderize them, because we don't want a crunchy bell pepper at all. Oh, man. I get some power real quick before my phone dies. I didn't realize I was that close to dying. Hold on. I got 5% power. We do not want to start this over. Give me a second here. All right, got juice. Get my lens off real quick. All right, so you're gonna parboil your bell peppers for about 10 minutes, okay? About 10 minutes. All right. And so that's what you're gonna do for about 10 minutes. Parboil them. And then take them out of the water and let them sit to the side. All right, so we're good on power right now. Red peppers are sweeter than all peppers. Yeah, they have a good little sweet flavor to them as well, I think. I like it. I'm gonna wash out a bowl real quick. And we're gonna take our ingredients and pour it inside the bowl.
so I can relocate. I want to have it in a bowl mixture. And I'll post the recipe and let you guys check it out and see if it's something you want to give a try at home. Most delicious. This is definitely a seafood lover's dish. If you're not a seafood lover, I do apologize, but this is definitely one meal you are going to absolutely love as a seafood lover. Okay, so we're getting it all mixed in. We're gonna go ahead and add in our breadcrumbs. Which is Italian breadcrumbs, okay? And the reason why we're using Italian breadcrumbs is because it's already seasoned. Okay, we don't have to do anything with it. So we're gonna go ahead and do a little dump right there. Mix it up. That's gonna take up a lot of the moisture in here as well. And I'm gonna take, yes, they do. Bell peppers come in different genders. All right, so we're gonna take one whole cup of cheese. This is a 2-cup bag, so I'm gonna use half the bag. That gives me my 1 cup. And I'm gonna mix this in here all together. As you can see the mixture here. So the reason why we're not using rice is because we have breadcrumbs as our filler to soak up all of the juice and the moisture in here. Ah, that smells good. I'm gonna throw a little bit hint of my Old Bay in here. Definitely wanna have a seafood flavor to it. Welcome, Nicole, how are you? And I think I'm gonna add a All right, Maria, thank you so much. Thank you. Have a blessed day. And a little bit more cheese. Can never have too much cheese in here. We're gonna make sure this mixture gets all the way through. And then we're gonna begin to stuff our bell peppers and put them in the oven. How about that? Y'all ready for that? Now, that process takes 30 to 35 minutes. If you wanna hold on for the whole process, hold on. If not, tune back in 30 minutes after I put them in the oven. We'll still be here making it do what it do. In the meantime, I say grab a glass, listen to some jazz, we're gonna have some fun. Yes. Very good looking mixture. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm going to take this mixture here, as you can see, right? See what it is? And I'm gonna take this and we're gonna stuff it inside of the bell peppers. Then I'm gonna top it with some more cheese. All right. This is delicious looking, man. I gotta taste it before I put it in here, I really do. I gotta make sure my seasoning is where I need it to be. Oh my God. That is delicious. I'm gonna do a little more dash of hot sauce. Okay. Oh man. I know this process is not a fast process. I had as much mise en place as I could have done without you guys missing out on how this is done. And so, that's how we got that. All right, so for the fun part. All right, so with your bell peppers, okay,
Keep in mind, we're going to add about a cup of water at the bottom of the pan when we do this. Yes, hot sauce, not bad stuff. Hot sauce is good. Say it with me, hot sauce is good. So, we're going to have the bell peppers. Once we stuff them, we're going to add a cup of water at the bottom, just to coat the bottom of the pan so we don't have our peppers sticking. Yes, Linda, we're having some fun. Miss Frowry, how we doing? This is delicious. So, let's get the stuffing. I'm gonna do half first of each one so I can make sure I have enough stuffing for them all. So I'm gonna stuff them halfway first. All right. Half of that one. Come on. That's a friend of mine, she got stuck. She was on her way over. Car died on the side of the highway. Let me see what she's saying on my tablet here. Give me a second. Come back, see how I was on. So, anyway, let me go ahead and finish stuffing these bell peppers. I was just trying to check a message someone was sending me on Instant Messenger that I was not able to watch because they have some car problems. So, alrighty. So, I'm halfway stuffing these just to make sure I got plenty of stuff. It looks like I'm going to have way more than enough to finish topping these off. So, we're going to go ahead and pack this one. We're gonna pack them. Fill it all the way up. All that seafood goodness inside of there. Oh, that's gonna be delicious. See there? Get them in there. Everyone says they want me to come cook for them, but if you fly me out somewhere, hey, I'll be more than happy to go, as long as it's on your dime. Zoo. I love to go travel and cook. I love to travel and I love to cook. So you can't beat me on, you can't miss me on either one of those. Traveling and cooking. For real. So if that's what you want me to do, by all means, fly me out to your location and I got you. So we're gonna go ahead and finish stuffing all these up as much as we can. And if you notice, I'm packing it in there and getting it going. Yeah. So as a personal chef, if you want to fly me to your home, wherever it may be, and say, hey, this is what you want me to cook, and we get everything good lined up, and we agree on all the terms, man, I'm ready to go. Terms. Yeah, there are terms of me flying out. I know I'm not staying at your house. You got to put me up in a hotel unless you got a nice guest room. I stay in the guest room. Yeah, because we got to keep our business separated from everything else. But this is business for me. And it's pleasure for me. But try not to mix the two. Yeah. I hear you, let's arrange that. Yeah, I'll go wherever if you make my ticket, you take care of my plane ticket, and you want me to come and cook, I'm there. Shoot, yeah, I'm ready to go. Just give me a couple of weeks' notice. That's all I need. Get myself together. So, yeah, we're really stuffing these. So, they're going to be packed. Yeah, background check, right? Ha, 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 ha. On them, not on me. Ha, 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 ha. Yeah. Make sure they're not crazy. Because I'm the one that's taking the risk coming out. Yeah. Send for me, Atlantic Star. I see you. Ha, ha, ha. Yeah, as long as we comply with the terms, we good. I think now I'm not gonna have much left over as far as filling goes, because it's getting on in here. This is the last one that I have to stuff. And notice the shell is real soft and tender. So that's what the parboiling with salt water does. It softens up your bell pepper, so it's not so hard when you do it. So see if I can get a little bit of this last stuffing in here, because I want to use all of it. And then we're going to top it off with some cheese. The oven is already hot. We're not waiting for it to get warm. It's ready to go. And so we can go ahead and make this happen real quick like. This one's a little splitting, but that's okay. It's gonna be all right. It's a little split down the side, but it's all right. We got all of our stuffing in here. I'm gonna go ahead and add my water into here so that when I put it in the oven, we're good to go. So we're adding water into the bottom of the pan just to coat the bottom of the pan. That's gonna add some steam, keep your moisture in here, and also it's gonna keep this from sticking to the bottom of the pan as well. So I'm gonna just push these to the edge of the pan here, so if they, just for some support, they don't fall over. And I'll let you guys see what this looks like in my pan. So, take a peek. Oh, I almost canceled the video. So, take a peek. Here's what we got inside the pan. All right. So everybody can see that? Really, the broth is not really going to change the flavor on the inside of this. I'm not opposed to using broth, but all I'm trying to do is get a little bit of a little bit of steam. I'm going to put these in the oven. They're at it's already at 350. It takes about 30 to 35 minutes to cook all the way, and we're going to get it where we need to get it. So now I'm going to take the rest of the cheese and I'm going to just top it off so we can get that to stay right there. Maybe not. It's okay. Some of this you'll be able to see. We're gonna go ahead and top this off with cheese. Vegetarian dish. Miss Tay, if you're watching, you crossed the parking lot. You need to bring yourself home. You crossed the parking lot. You better come home. Yeah, so I'm just topping the rest of this off with cheese. We're gonna have it nice and cheesy and melted on the top. That's all we're doing is adding the last of the cheese. No, this is, every recipe is just an instructional guideline. You're free to modify any recipe you feel you wanna modify to your liking. Recipe is just a guideline. So if you have a particular like or dislike, well, apply it to your recipe. You know, it's nothing wrong with that at all. You're the one that has to eat it. So please, by all means, modify the recipe as you see fit as to what you like. I always tell people, recipes are just a guideline. They're open to interpretation and modifications to what you like. So this is David's version of what I'm doing. That's it. It does have breadcrumbs. I'm using Italian breadcrumbs on the inside. I'm doing seafood stuffed bell peppers. I'm using shrimp, crawfish, and lump crab meat. If you're not a crawfish person, don't use crawfish. If you're not a shrimp person, don't use shrimp. But if you don't use any seafood, it's not seafood stuffed bell peppers, all right? So we got to keep it on the note that what we're doing is it's a seafood stuffed pasta. I mean, seafood stuffed bell peppers.
And so if you don't like a particular item, change it. Put it to whatever you like. I mean, whatever you feel you want to do, it does not have to be exactly how I'm doing it. All right. So we're going to go ahead and put these in the oven. We're looking at 30 to 35 minutes. So I'm going to put these in the oven. I'll show you what this looks like real quick. That's with the cheese on top. Okay. All righty. So we got that in all set up. Let's put this in the oven. It's now, what, 850? 850, so we're looking at 30 minutes to do this here. So 30 minutes from now, we're looking at what, 820 or 920? And we have some fun with it. So in the meantime, for those of you who are just joining, what I'm gonna do also here now is cut up a little bit of parsley to add onto the deal there. And if you have to go, that's fine. That's the end of the instructional portion. For those who wanna hang around, chit chat, enjoy the music, have a glass of wine, and talk and ask questions, I'm available for that. But let's not utilize the instant messenger to do that, please. So I can sit here and take any of your questions. If you feel embarrassed to ask anything in front of everybody else, inbox me later on, but not now. Alrighty. So I'm just chopping up a little bit of parsley because I want this as a topping on top of it. So when I take pictures of it, it's gonna be awesome. Yes, you can have the recipe. So let me give you the recipe. Let me know who all wants the recipe and if you're ready to take it down. And also, as a matter of fact, I'm gonna post it once this is over with. So don't so much worry about it. I'm gonna post the recipe up on my page. It takes about 30 to 35 minutes to cook. Yeah. No, I didn't add any cream cheese to this at all. That's not a bad option, but I didn't use any cream cheese. Let's see. Lakeisha, thanks for joining in. Basically, what we made today was a seafood stuffed bell peppers. And the seafood that we used was lump crab meat, shrimp, and we actually added in some crawfish tails. You know, we gotta make a little bit of Cajun to it, add some crawfish to it, add a little crawfish, and we just made it a Cajun meal, you know what I'm saying? So, all I'm gonna do now is cut up a little bit of parsley, just as some garnishment on top of the dish. So when I take pictures of them, it'll be good to go. Hello, Trees, how are you? You're late. I know some of you saying you were going to show up tonight. You here? Best to be late than not show at all. I appreciate you. Thank you. If you guys like what you're seeing here, please share it. Who that, baby? You know it. Share it on your page for me, please. I'm just trying to put myself out there. And if those who want to watch, they're enjoying what they see, ask them to share it as well. We're trying to get as many likes as possible and as many views as possible on the videos. All right, so we got our parsley all chopped up, ready to go. We're going to top that off on top of there and make it do what it do. Thank you guys for sharing the video so much. That's all right. We're just having some fun. Now that we're in there, we got about till 8:20 before our actual meal is finished, and then we'll take a look at it. I'm gonna break one open, and I'm gonna let them cool, and I'm gonna refrigerate them because I know I'm not gonna eat them. I'm full. The next thing after dinner is a cigar and some wine. We're still in the first glass, so we're doing good. Thank you, Pamela, for sharing. Appreciate it. And if you would, the rest of you, if you don't mind sharing the video, I would greatly appreciate it. Man, you guys are awesome. I appreciate you guys.
for hanging with me and watching me enjoy what I do. I do this for you guys. I do this because I love to cook, and I want to show you guys that, hey, we can all share in the craft of what we do. I'm drinking a Cabernet Sauvignon. We can share in what we do. And what I say is each one teach one. I know that's an old saying, it does not belong to me. But if we just take our craft and show it to someone else and help them get where we are, man, this world would be a lot better place. Hey, Sharon, how you doing? So if you're good at something, find somebody and show them what you do. It's not, don't be worried about them surpassing you, because what's for you is for you and what's for them is for them. You know, so take time to share your craft. Times cookware. I just try to buy quality cookware, okay? Something I know is gonna last me a long time, something that's not gonna wear out real quick, and it's safe, and it cooks evenly. That's one of the main things I look at cookware. I bought a set of Paula Deen's cook sets before she got her line got pulled off the shelves. I love them. They're very good cookware, and I haven't had any problems out of them. And I think I've had them now probably about 3 years, and they're still in great shape. And I do a lot of cooking. All right, Sherelle, not a problem. Thank you. So it's just a matter of what you prefer. But I always tell people, and this is true for a lot of things, quality comes first, price comes second. If you always put price first, you're gonna get what you pay for, and sometimes that's not much. All right, and I would rather buy 15 things one time than to buy that same thing 15 different times. You get what I'm saying? So buy some quality stuff. And if price is an issue, wait. Because quality is always needs to come first, always. Thank you so much, Stephanie. Thank you, Sherelle, for sharing the video before you left. I just try to have some fun with you guys and share what I do. I don't care about making money doing this, because it's not about money. This is sinking something, okay? So for those of us who love to cook, and for those who cook because we gotta eat, and you wanna try something different, you know, this is what I'm doing this for, is to kind of show you guys something different, something that's affordable. You can go to the store and buy this stuff relatively cheap. Bell peppers, man, those orange bell peppers and the red bell peppers were only, they were two for like a dollar and something cents a piece. Two for a dollar. The green ones were 88 cents a piece. So, I mean, this stuff is cheap, partially it's cheap. Notice everything that I bought was grown. The onions, the celery, the parsley, the onions. I mean, that stuff was grown. It's nothing out of the way. And then we took seafood, you know. No GMOs. These are not genetically modified organisms. These are just regular old stuff. Cornbread. Bread crumbs. Italian seasoned bread crumbs. Only thing is take some bread, toasted it out, crunched it up, add some seasoning to it. Same thing. So, these things are healthy for you. And I tell people, it's better to buy butter than anything that's not butter. That imitation stuff is processed and has a lot of stuff in it that probably that's not good for you. You know, back in the day, they used to churn milk to make butter. That's where butter comes from. If it didn't come from a cow, then it's processed. And hey, the onions I used on this one, I did use my red onions. Those are my favorites. I do it for color, and then it has a little bit of a sweeter taste to me. What's up, Dorothy? How you doing, cousin? We're just making it do what it do up in here. Thank you, Mr. Cleveland. How are you? Captain Jack. Houston, Texas. How are you, sir? Shindana, how are you? Thank you for joining. I appreciate you. Basically, what we did today was stuff seafood, bell peppers. We got them in the oven at this point. We got everything done, sauteed off everything, and so now we have them in the oven. Right. Now, these bell peppers will stretch. If you do 6 or 7 of these things, depending on the size of your family, they'll last you a few days, at least a couple of days, at least 2 days, today's meal and tomorrow's meal. I think the next thing I want to do is some red beans and rice, because I want to show you how I do my red beans and rice and how you can get that flavor that you seem, you really can't seem to get when you go other places. You're like, and mine just don't taste the same. I'm going to show you why yours don't taste the same and how you can get it to taste the same. How about that? Red beans and rice. I'm probably going to do that one next week. I think what I'm going to start doing is I'm probably going to limit this to once a week. I'm generally off on Tuesdays. Can you freeze? You can just about freeze anything now. You can freeze just about anything. Yeah, red beans and rice, I love it. That's one of my favorite things to do. And then I do add some sausage to it as well. And we'll show you how we're going to cut all those up and put that in there. So red beans and rice will be next week. I started to do it today, but I didn't soak my beans. And I didn't want to hurry up and do it. And, you know, you can boil them real quick and then let them soak from there. But I wanted to give them the full overnight treatment of soaking. So we can make the beans absorb as much as that water to release the gas. So you don't have to release the gas later. with freezing anything, so let me tell you this. I have never frozen the bell peppers before. Never frozen anything stuffed like this. So I really don't know. So I'm going to tell you, I don't know. Yeah. So for those of you... if you can, I'm sorry about the little gas joke there, but really what happens is beans take time to absorb and that moisture and release the gases. And if you don't give it time to do that in the pot or in the water, when you cook them, your body won't have to do the rest of the work. So, you know what I mean. beans can be done in a pressure cooker. I do have a pressure cooker up here. That definitely eliminates the time on there as well. You can cut down time dramatically. Oh man, you just reminded me, Annabelle, about my pressure cooker. Man, I have done a whole chicken in a pressure cooker in 15 minutes, done to the center. Pressure cookers, man, if you don't have one, they're absolute bomb. Yeah, I'm sure Aruba has internet if you wanted to catch it. Yeah. But anyway, so, man, I thank you guys for sticking with me. We got about another 19 minutes before this is done. And I think you guys are going to thoroughly enjoy it. I'm looking forward to them coming out and seeing what they're going to do. Like I said, this is my first time doing it. Let me turn the I got the rack too high. I can't even see them while they're in the oven. So, 3 electric ones. Yeah. Oh yeah. The pressure cookers are the bomb. That's what I have. I mean, yeah, pressure cooker, man. Can you cook some gumbo? Man, that's some fun. Expensive though. And then I gotta freeze all that stuff, and I don't want to do gumbo because you can't make a small amount. I really can't. You know, then I gotta make my roux, and that flour is gonna smoke up the house trying to brown it to get it where I want it. Man, that's a lot of work. Yeah, if you freeze the mixture without stuffing the bell peppers, exactly. That would be the best bet. Do not freeze the actual bell pepper, freeze the filling. And then thaw that out and then stuff it later. Absolutely correct. Island foods. I have not really ventured into island foods. I do have a source for some Jamaican seasoning, authentic Jamaican seasoning. So I might look into that. Everybody's saying gumbo. man, you talk about bacon chicken. You must have missed the video I did with the stuffed leg quarter, which I baked in the oven. I stuffed it with rice, a mushroom rice mixture, and the whole leg quarter was stuffed from thigh to the end of the drumstick. Take it back a look at it and watch it.
Welcome back, Stacey. I'm sorry to hear about your situation. Do you still want to come by and eat one? Let me know. I can pick you up. Chicken curry. Oh, man. Yeah. No, hold on. Now, you know what? Now, I do a curry. No, you're not going to miss it. Where are you at, Stacey? I can pick you up. Billie Jean, go back. It's on my page. It's listed as stuffed seafood. Stuffed leg quarter. Go back. You can see it. You can watch the video. Yeah. But Stacey, I still have the bell pepper. They're in the oven cooking right now. I'm not finished with them yet. We got another about 15 minutes on those in the oven. So we hadn't gotten there yet. All right. Come pick you up. Stephanie, where are you? Let me hear this one. I gotta find out where you at, for real. Where you at? Stephanie Lee, where are you? Uh-huh, that's what I thought. Hey, but Stacey, let me know, and yeah, see, that's what I wanted to see. They San Antonio, right? Okay, sure. All right. No problem. I'll be there in 15 minutes, definitely. Yeah. Yeah. So anyway, Stacey, let me know, and I'll swing by and come get you. Or I can drop it off, however you like. Yeah, you're going to love it anyway. Either way it goes. Tori, what's up? Billy, what's up? You want to come get one, Billy? I think you're local. Yeah, it takes me 15 minutes to get to San Antonio from Dallas. I'm going to make it happen. Since you say you want me to pick you up, give me 15 minutes. Yes, curry chicken, yeah. Love it. Absolutely love it. Yeah. Yeah, I can do curry chicken for sure. Yeah. I love it when she's coming out there. I'm jealous. Oh hell. I'm sorry. You wish. FedEx your plate. Hold on. Okay, FedEx a plate. I'm still happy. Okay. Hey, Stacey, I need to come join me for a glass of wine. Yeah. Oh, yeah. I want to come get one. Well, come on. If you're in Arlington, come on. Midtown Cedar Hill Apartments, look it up. That's where I'm at. If you show up, text me when you're in the parking lot. Hit me up, I give you my apartment number if you actually show up. Let's see here. Oh, I told her she can't leave family behind. Michelle, you want me to come pick you up for real? Let me know for real now. I got six of them. I'm not going to eat all this. I'm back. That wasn't nice. What are you talking about, Sherry? Yeah, another glass, please. All right. Yeah, get some wine. Hey, I started this at 8 o'clock. I gave y'all a couple hours notice. This is what's going to be happening. Then get your glass, get your drink. 8 o'clock, we're going to be on and popping. So, you can make your own. Stephanie, you said, bring me mines in. San Antonio, okay, sure, all right. Wine and dine, yeah, we're having some fun. Absolutely, having some fun. Mm-hmm. Yes, wave on. So anyway, second glass, I'm just now starting my second glass. And we doing pretty good so far.
No, I'm drinking a Cabernet Sauvignon by Liberty Creek. It's pretty good. Treese says, I'm about to take a flight. To where? Where you going, Treese? I see them kisses there, Stacy. Mm-hmm. You should have been over here. Oh, no, I'm not even tipsy, baby. This is only my second glass of wine. And trust me, I can drink this whole bottle without even, not even stumbling. You're about to go. Treese says she's about to take a flight to my house. Okay. I don't think so. Oh, Marilyn, if you're in Grand Prairie, you might as well make a trip. Come on. You guys will come on. I know you're joking, Treese. Oh, snap. Blowing kisses. Oh, I'm catching them all. No, I'm not. Hey, I used to be a comedian in another life, I'm sure. I'm sure of it. I like having fun. I like laughing and joking. Life's too short to be running around mad all the time. Let that junk go, man. I'm waiting to taste some food then, Treese. You know, catch that plane and come on over here and cook. Mm-hmm. Okay. Mm-hmm. Sure. Anyway, again, Lord, I need that type of attention. You get it? Yeah, my friends are all over the place. These are all my friends. These are my Facebook friends. You ain't ready. I ain't ready, really? You think so? Hey. Thank you, Linda. I'm just having fun. I'm just being me. I don't know how to be anything else. I'm just having fun. And Melita, what's up, buddy? But anyway, just enjoying myself, you know? Yeah. Let me know where you're at, Stacy. As long as you ain't got me driving to Timbuktu. If you guys don't mind, take this video, share it on your page if you don't mind. I'm trying to get as many views as possible with this thing that I'm trying to do, sharing my cooking videos. I know a lot of people don't have the time. They have busy in their lives and they don't have time to do what I'm doing. But this is what I love to do. I love to cook. And I didn't mind taking you guys' suggestions. And mind you, I had several people come back to me with stuffed bell peppers. And then I say, and then they miss some people mention crab cakes, salmon croquettes, and stuff like that. And I said, well, you know what? I like the stuffed bell pepper idea and decided to stuff it with something I like. So thanks to all of you that suggested that we do stuffed bell peppers of some sort. And I took my take on this one here. Hey, Gail. Yeah, I'm missing my, somebody took my stuff. But Gail, if you're on there, if you're on your way, oh, hold on, Gail. Let me back this up. Hold on. Gail must have just missed this. So, Gail says, I'm missing my chef. Yeah, she says, I'm in Arlington, R20. Gail says she's on her way. Okay, Gail. Now, Midtown City Hill Apartments right behind Walmart off of 1382. If you're coming here, let me know. In the meantime, you're going to get that look. Yeah. My Saints hat, I actually had a Saints apron as well. I don't know where that's at right now. So, anyway. Yeah, this recipe is going to be the bomb. I'm waiting. Probably got another about 7 minutes, and we're going to check it and see where it's at. We should be looking real delicious and juicy and ready to rock and roll. And we're going to have some fun with it. But once again, like I asked, if you guys could share this on your page, and if you enjoyed what you saw,
share it. Because I'm sharing with you, share with your friends. And invite them out the next time to watch, you know? What else we got? If you're in the, serious business though. If you're in the Arlington, DeSoto, Cedar Hill, Lancaster, Fort Worth, if that's not too far for you, and you want to come by and have some of this, I'm not going anywhere. I'm going to be up. I'm not going to eat this stuff. I got 6 bell peppers. I cannot eat them all. So please, please take me serious when I say you're more than welcome to come over and try. If I don't have enough wine, bring your favorite beverage with you. And I got everything else. Yeah. Hey, I just did the invite for anybody that's there out there. Guys and women, I don't care. Guys, come on over, man. I mean, this is a free-for-all. Do what you do. I'm not trying to holler at any one particular person. So if you see somebody, y'all connect, please knock yourself out. Now, both of y'all can sit down and watch the video together. You go get some wine. I got plenty of wine. Not for everybody. Not everybody. Let's see here. I've been fishing, so tomorrow, nice. You know, I love fishing, so you already know that. Baytown, I'm sorry. Man, that's sorry about that, Stormy. You had to be down that far. I need to get my, send your fam the link. I need to get my Saints. Yeah, I gotta go back and get some more because I can't find it. I was looking for it for the event I went to this weekend, and I was not able to find that. I can't find it anywhere, but that's okay. All right, we got about 5 more minutes on the oven. This should be done. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get ready to plate it and so we can make it look pretty. And you know I gotta post pictures on Facebook on what we did. You need to stop talking and hurry up and get here and pick me up now. San Antonio, okay. Okay, San Antonio, got it. I'll be there in a minute. Okay, Marilyn, I hear you. I'ma hold you to a dead serious, right? All right, dead serious, I got you. I told you 15 minutes, yeah, I know. Well, 15 minutes. I can't leave with the food in the oven, baby. You're gonna have to hold tight. You got to wait. I can't leave. Okay, so I told you 15 minutes, right? 10 minutes ago, when the stuff had a whole 15 minutes more to go in the oven. Man, that stuff would have been burnt. I said I'd be there in 15 minutes. That means 30 minutes round trip. We got some crispy, crispy stuffed bell peppers if I did that. Oh, no. Not too much wine. Actually, like I said, this is only my second glass. I am far from it. I can drink this whole bottle. We'd be chilling. But anyway, I like having fun. Yeah. Yes, Michelle, you know how we do. Having lots of fun. Lashima, thank you for coming in and watching. If you caught this video at this point, we got about another 2 or 3 minutes before the finished product comes out of the oven, and we're gonna make it do what it do. Ooh.
I'm sorry.
Okay, yeah. Dion, what's up? Long time no see. Oh my God. I'm not gonna say a word. I'm gonna leave it alone. Woo! I'm gonna leave that alone. Oh my. Yeah. I can't do it. I'm not gonna do it. Oh Jesus. Oh my God. That was too much. I'm sorry. Oh, hold on now. Hold on. I'm sorry. Yeah, Stephanie. I'm sorry. Oh, Jesus.
Sorry. Stop it.
Oh, my God. Oh, man. Okay. Oh, my God. Satori, you know exactly what I'm talking about. Oh, okay. Okay, so we're about to check the bell peppers here. Oh, God. Whew. Man. Too much wine, not enough education. I'm sorry. I'm gonna leave that one alone. Yeah. Jesus Christ. Woo! Yeah. Yeah. Mm. All right, so let's go ahead and pull these out. We're gonna pull them out of the oven. Yeah. We ready to see them too. We all are. Man, I am sure enjoying the laughs with you guys. Yes, Michelle. I heard you. Give me a minute. Oh my. Yes. Man, if I tell you, I will try. I will have to put on my face. Woo! I don't do it. Don't do it, Tori. Please don't do it. Don't do it. Okay, so I think I got enough charge here. We should be able to detach this here and go ahead and let you see what we got going on here. Oh, we have 15%. I'm gonna try to go ahead and hurry up. Do this real quick. This is what they look like. All right. Nice and cheesy. And delicious. All righty. Now, the way we're going to do this is I'm going to put them on a plate. But I want to do, I'm going to pick one pepper and put it on the plate, and I'm gonna split it, and we're gonna make it look nice and pretty on the plate, okay? So give me a second to get that together, and we don't wanna die, because I said I only got 15%, you know, live. So, give me a second. Got the bell pepper on a plate. I want to see how I want to do this, and so so that we can actually see the stuffing. That's warm, baby. That's warm. This is my first time plating something like this, so give me a second. Mm-hmm.
Actually, let's just leave it like this. A little bit of parsley on it. Across the plate. We'll dust it up a little bit. We'll do it this way first.
We'll do it this way first. And let's go here. We'll dust it up like that. How about that? Dusting the plate up. You can't see. Who can't see this? Let me know. Tell me you can see it. Did you open your eyes up now, Treece? So, let me grab one more and put it on the plate.
Grab one more. Actually, that's gonna put all three on the plate. We're gonna do all three because I have three different colors. We're gonna throw a little parsley on top of those. You know, sprinkle it out. We'll sprinkle them out and then spread them apart a little bit.
All right, so now let's do what all three on the plate. What do you think about that? Look at that. Look at that. That's seafood stuffing all the way through there. Isn't that beautiful? That would be the picture I want right there. That would be the picture. Just like that. Thank you, thank you, thank you. So, here's for the good part. I want to cut this open so you can see what the inside of this looks like. How about that?
Let's cut one open. Ready? Let's just take one and cut it open. How about that? I'm going to take the one that's already split right here. We're going to lay it down. And I want to take the cheese cap and put it on top. How about that? That's different. Butterfly it open. Let's take a little bit of that and just go to the side right there. So I want you to see all the seafood, the crab meat that's on the inside.
Real good. And all I did was splice up in the bell pepper. Thank you, thank you, Shanana.
What do you think about it? Okay, I need everybody that's watching this right now, everybody hit the like button all at the same time right now. Everybody go, 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 go. Like it, like it, like it, like it, like it. Let's see everybody go. Everybody hit the like button, thumbs up, hearts, whatever you want to do, like it right now. Let's see it, let's see it, let's see it. This is the bomb. Try this at home. I'm gonna post this recipe up. Everybody go. We're gonna make sure that this is done. You guys are gonna love this. When you get home, I promise you, when you try this at home, you're gonna love it. Thank you so much. I'm so glad you guys stuck around long enough to see this and make it happen. Some people got a little impatient. They couldn't wait, but there it is. This is a seafood stuffed bell pepper. It is with crab meat, lump crab meat that is, shrimp and crawfish. It is the absolute bomb. And you know I'm about to take a fork and taste this right now because it's got to be delicious. Gotta get a little bit of that cheesiness in there with it. A little bit more cheesiness. Not all of it, but I want to take all of it. But we're gonna get a cheesiness on there. All right. Shrimp. Oh my God. Thank you, Jetty. I tell you, this is absolutely delicious. It is delicious. Hold on. Mercedes said she just licked her iPad. If you lick that iPad, baby, you're a bad mama jamma. Well, look here. Again, if you guys are in the area, I got some of this left over. If I tell you, you gotta taste it with some of the bell pepper. That's what I'm missing. So I'm gonna taste some of this. A little bit of the bell pepper on the end of it. Because of course, that's what we did. We stuffed it. Absolutely delicious. Bell pepper is really tender. I didn't know if I was gonna have an appetite. They don't look. What's up, Scott? Scott? I just made seafood stuffed bell peppers with lump crab meat, crawfish, and shrimp. Shipmate, if I tell you, your boy did it again. If I tell you, it's delicious. It's the absolute bomb. Absolute bomb. Absolute bomb. So you know, hold on a second. I'm gonna take this. Woo! It's good. I ain't gonna lie. Especially with the bell pepper, it's really good. Well, hey. All right, if you're serious about Michelle, hey, Michelle, if you're serious, I come get you now. Oh man, stuck in San Jose, trying to find a smoke spot. Hey brother, my smoke spot is gonna be on the patio tonight. With a cigar, some red wine, and maybe somebody to chit chat with while I'm out there. Yeah. So yeah, we're having some good times here, man. Sorry you got stuck out there. Make it home safe, brother. Yeah. So. Left my cabinet up there, huh? So anyway, this is where we at. Um, That's a $350 fine here. What do you mean? Oh, you can't smoke there. Okay. It is not spicy at all, Gail. With everything that I put in it, it's not spicy at all.
So, it actually tastes pretty damn good, if I must say so myself. But I need somebody else to come try it. For real. You know, you can do the country way. You pick it up and... Just bite into it. So, you know, I gotta clean my plate up a little bit so that I can take a picture of what we got here.
Sure.
But I tell you, this has been fun to make. I enjoyed doing it. All right. Yeah, I'm sorry, Deanne. Where's the food? Okay, hold on. I'm about to show you the plate once more. She wanted to see where the food was. She showed up late. So we have it right here.
Get a lot of this out your way here. And the food is right here. There's the food, stuffed bell peppers. It's all right, there it is. Zeddy, I hear you. That is my stuffed bell pepper. Seafood stuffed bell pepper. Oh, they taste just the same. All of them taste the same. Stephanie. They all taste the same. And I split one open just so you guys could see the inside of what it looks like. That's what the inside looks like, split open. See all the crab meat in there? Jetty, I'm sure you will. And there's the rest of them, right there. Yes. Yeah, it is off the chain, if I tell you. I'm sitting up here eating this like right now. Delicious. Gotta cut into some of the bell pepper. Oh yeah. Yeah. It was lump crab meat that I bought at Costco. It's $17.99 a pound. but it's delicious. Recipe's coming. Recipe is coming. As a matter of fact, I can do that while I'm online with you guys now. How about that?
Man, that is so good. I have five more that have not been touched, Stephanie. All right, so here we go. I'm gonna go ahead and post the recipe online. Family discussion, Stephanie, I'm gonna let y'all have that one. Yeah, get the yellow ones. They'll probably go well. All right, they'll go well. Now, if you want them to be black and gold, a good thing would be is to roast them on a stove. Or if you have a gas stove, put them over the fire and roast them. The roasted peppers is delicious. I'm trying to catch you some of your messages here. Just to let you know, okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and hood grilling. No, that's not hood grilling. That's actually how you roast a red pepper or green pepper on a stove, on an open flame. So if you have a gas stove, you turn the flame on and then put that on there. Yeah. Gail, you say gonna hire me to do them? Okay, well that sounds good. I'm gonna show you the seasoning. I'm gonna lay it all out to you guys, what I did, and so you can see for yourself what it is. So let's see here. Let me see if I can do this easy way. What's up, Mercedes? Yeah, I say so. So let me get this recipe together and kind of show you what I did. Alrighty, let's see here. You know, a lot of times, guys, it's a lot of these recipes you can find online and then just do them the way you want to do them. No, that wasn't it. All right, Marilyn. Oh, the red beans and rice, definitely. Definitely. It's gonna happen. Definitely gonna happen. Let's see. I don't think I got it. And you got everything except for the meat. Well, I use crab meat, lump crab meat. I use crawfish tails and shrimp. That's what I used. So, yeah. Good night, Gail. Thank you so much.
I'm glad you guys stuck around for it. It was a little long, but we got the cooking part out of the way pretty quickly. And so that's one thing we can say. I didn't kill too much of your time in the cooking process. The longest part that took was to actually bake it in the oven. I'm gonna copy this. So I'm gonna go ahead and put the bell pepper recipe online now. Let's do this, a seafood stuffed bell peppers. Are y'all ready to see this here? Thank you, Stephanie. Glad you enjoyed it. Had fun with you guys. It was an enjoyable time with you guys, for real. And I threw in an option for you to do some, I threw an option for some, chopped green peppers, but you don't have to add. As a matter of fact, I'm going to take it out of there. I'm not going to put that in there. We're almost there. Now, some of this, again, you can modify to whatever it is that you like or don't like, okay? This is just strictly a guideline to what we're doing, okay? I need one, so... Yes, Rita, I'm single as it comes. All right, so I'm posting that now. And then I'll, Jetty, good night. Take care. So you can see that portion. Yeah. Man, it's almost cigar time. All right, so let me go to my page and see if that posted up. And then I'll go ahead and give you the instructions behind that. X3 has not shown up yet. Let's see what's happening with that. Are you kidding me? That post didn't show. Interesting. Yeah, single. You want the smell of the cigar? Okay, you keep playing. Michelle, we're going to talk when this is over with. If you're for real. Matter of fact, inbox me your address if you're serious. I can pick you up.
if you're serious. Ha 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 ha. Hey, that's cool. I don't have a problem with that. She wants to smell the cigar. I posted this recipe and I promise you I'm a little aggravated. It hadn't showed up yet. What do you mean, Stephanie? She is literally 15 minutes away. I mean literally 15 minutes away. You're like freaking 4 hours away. So, what's up, Miss Stewart? How are you? That ain't all. Yeah, that's all. We cleared that up already. What are you talking about? By the way, yeah, I didn't do any enchiladas tonight, love. I didn't. I just posted all that. Maybe I didn't hit post. I don't know what I did. Let me try that again. Let's try this again. So we're trying to post the, let's see, welcome Teddy, welcome Dylan. Hey, what's up, man? What's up, Victor? How's it going? A pina colada cake? No, I have not. At all. I have not cooked a pina colada cake at all, actually. Stephanie, stop it. Okay, Stephanie, it's like that. Okay, so here's what I did. I still have it on the plate right here, so you can check it out. Stuffed bell peppers. We did it with a seafood stuff. Seafood stuffed, and this is what it looks like on the inside. If I can get the focus. That's what it looks like right there. Seafood stuffed bell pepper. Mm-hmm. Absolutely delicious. So, that's what we did. I'm trying to post the recipe online. So give me a minute here. Hey, there we go. All right. I just posted up the recipe, okay? And then I'll give you the instructions behind it. Because I do need to edit this. I'm sorry. Give me just a moment and I can go ahead and add in the cooking instructions, the directions on this one. Give me just a second. Alrighty. And let's add the instructions at the bottom. Thank you.
Billy, dinner is now. Yeah, hey, Brianna, I've had to call the police several times this month already regarding the noise pool at the pool. And even though I got them to finally put signs up as to what time the pool closes, it's 5 minutes, 6 minutes before it closes, and they still care and all this in the afternoon, unfortunately. So yeah, it's crazy. Yeah. Your favorite juice, absolutely. Yeah, I'm at home, Brianna. I'm at home, so. Yeah, unfortunately, they have no concept of time, or they don't care. That's the problem. So. It is what it is. So, I'm going to go ahead, ladies and gentlemen. I'm going to cut this one out. Thank you so much for joining me. Sophia, I'm sorry you caught me at the end of this. Go back and watch the video. Like it, share it. You can also, you know, speed through the video and get to the good stuff when you get done, when you start watching it. Just take, go where the little dot is and just slide it across the bar, and you can speed this up. Thank you guys for coming out and hanging out with me. For those of you who stuck with me for the entire process, God bless you. I know it took a minute, but we had a little bit of fun with it. I enjoyed what we were doing. I enjoyed the interaction. I enjoyed the conversation. I welcome your questions. I thank you for it. I hope I've answered all of your questions. If I have not answered any of your questions, please inbox me with anything you have questions regarding what we did. I'm going to post some pictures up real quick to kind of show you what it is. For those of you who are in the area, hey, inbox me. I'll shoot you my address and come on over. I still got these things sitting here and somebody needs to eat them because I'm not going to be able to do it all. I can't do it. But anyway, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Not only like this video, I ask you to share it with your friends, please. Thank you so much. I'm trying to get as many views as possible on this here and hopefully you guys like it. I see you guys are liking on the post of what it does for this crab meat, this stuff. Seafood bell pepper. I'm seeing all of the comments are popping up on it now. Why am I not married by choice? I'm not looking for a woman, so don't pray for to send me one. I ain't trying to be married now, so don't pray that I get married. I'm good. Trust me, for now, I'm good. Been down that highway a few times. I'm good right now. I'm just in taking time and enjoy David, you know. And I think everybody should take some time and enjoy who they are and enjoy what they do. So, again, this is recipe. It's just a guideline. If you're not a crawfish person, you, by all means, substitute it with whatever you like. If you're not a seafood person, this recipe is not for you because it is strictly crab meat, shrimp, and crawfish tails. So, if you decide that this is not for you, well, stick to the traditional stuffed bell peppers would be your ground meat, some rice, tomato paste, and all that good stuff. It's boring. It's the same old stuff. Had all your life. Do something different. And that's what I try to do. I try to do something that's different and something that's new. It was new for me as well. And so taking something and putting a different spin on it. So if you would, Jackie, Javon, thank you guys for joining in. I'm sorry you guys caught me at the end of this video, but go back and take a look. As a matter of fact, I'm not going to deprive you of this right here. I'm going to show you this here. This was the end result of what we did. Stuffed bell peppers. Okay. The end result. And the insides of it looks about like that. Let's get it in focus. There we go. I can always use some help in the kitchen, Regina. Always, always, always.
That is the seafood stuffed bell pepper. So, if you guys like that, pass it on. I posted the recipe, and there it is. All right. So,
for those of you that, like I said, stuck around, I hope you enjoyed it. I hope that you enjoyed your libations. At the same time, I enjoy mine, and we're cooking. My show is called Cooking at Home with Chef David. So, I hope you enjoyed it. Share it with your friends. Hashtag Cooking at Home with Chef David. So, I hope you guys enjoy it. I'm going to post this up and let everyone take a look at it. And I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you and God bless you.